When using a triple output power supply, it can sometimes be risky to just simply turn on all the outputs. A lot of devices need to be powered up in a very specific order, or you could damage them. Today we're going to look at a way to protect your device using a power supply mode called sequencing. Hi, I'm Daniel Bogdanoff, and I'm here with Bill Griffith, one of our power supply folks here at Keysight.
Thanks for having me.
Many devices or models require multiple bias or rail voltages, and devices such as FPGAs require the voltages to be turned on and off in a set sequence. If you're working with devices that have specific timing requirements, you'll want to use a power supply with power sequencing.
Power supply sequencing allows you to automatically set voltage outputs and delays according to a pre-scripted pattern of your choosing. This means you won't have to manually turn on different channels or manually set output voltages, helping you avoid accidental damage.
So let's look up how to set up power sequencing. We're going to use the E36312A. If you're using a different supply, your menus might look different. Also, instead of powering up an FPGA, we're going to power up the board inside of these lights that Bill brought with him, so it'll be obvious when power gets applied to those lights. So Bill, where do we start?
The first step is to set up each of the outputs for the correct voltage and current limits. The power supply has three outputs. All are independent and isolated, so it's easy to set up the voltages and not have to worry about a common ground. Once we've done that, it's time to set up our delays. I'll configure our on delays and our off delays for each channel. The on delay is how long it waits to turn on after you've started the sequence, and the off delay is how long it waits once you've initiated the end of sequence.
The delays can be set with millisecond resolution, but realize that power supply outputs take 10 to 50 milliseconds to reach their programmed voltages. We're going to use rather long delays so that we can see each output turn on and off.
Now that everything's set up, we're ready to connect to our lights and start our sequence. I'll press the on all button, and you can see the outputs turn on with their respective delays. Likewise, you can turn off the outputs and see the turn-off delays. Some devices can be damaged if they're not powered down in the correct order.
What if you need more than three voltages? You can actually couple and sync multiple supplies together using the digital I/O ports on the back.
Once we've physically connected the I/O pins, we'll have to configure the digital I/O port. The digital I/O port can be used for many different tasks. I will configure pin 2 and 3 of both supplies to be set to couple on and couple off.
A quick fun UI fact that Bill taught me, the meter view button acts as a home button and is an easy way to exit out of any menu tree.
With the digital I/O configured, we will set up the coupling in the first power supply. On the second power supply, we'll select the outputs to be enabled upon receiving the signal. I've chosen two channels. We can also set the output delays from the same screen.
Lastly, we need to check the output voltage and current limit on each output. Not checking this is a great way to damage your device. So now let's put this all together.
To start it up, we'll push the on all button.
When sequencing is set up, the on all button will start up the sequence. When you're done, you can hit the same button to start the off sequence.
Right, all the outputs will be turned off in a predefined sequence.
So a quick recap, some devices require sequencing to be properly powered on and off. For tests requiring a larger number of channels, power supplies can actually be coupled together. Finally, we learned that we shouldn't trust Bill to program our city's traffic lights.
I find that I can often borrow a second or third power supply for a test and promptly return them, as it takes very little time to set up the additional power supplies.
So that's all for today, Bill. Thank you for coming out and setting this up with me. If power supply sequencing is something you use or would like to use in your setup, let us know in the comments. Of course, make sure to subscribe to the Keysight Labs YouTube channel. And if this video is helpful, give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.